Hi everyone, today we are looking at the second session of module 1 for 8th standard, chapter 14, World of Sounds. In this session we will be looking at the following objectives. Sound is a longitudinal wave. Longitudinal wave has four characteristics, which are amplitude, wavelength, frequency and speed. The session is divided into three parts, the opening, the main creation and the closure. For the opening, you ask the children to sit in groups of two and you will demonstrate this activity. You will need two paper cups, sellotape, rubber band and scissors. Keep the ends of the cup together like this and stick the sellotape around them. Once you secure them, put a rubber band around the model. One child needs to keep it against the ear and the other child will pluck it like this. They need to see different sounds that it can be made. They just need to demonstrate this and hear the sounds. So each child take turns. And then give them the materials for them to make this. While the children are doing this, you call 6 to 8 child to come to your table and show them the next activity. For that activity, you will need a small paper cup with water in it and a rubber band around it. Make sure that the cup is steady on the table, so push it down with your two fingers and gently pluck the rubber band. When you pluck the rubber band, the water will displace slightly, showing a longitudinal wave. After all the students have finished both the activities, you ask the children what they saw in both the activities and what they heard. They will come up with answers like vibration, wave, etc. Tell them about the fact that the particles are vibrating and it forms a wave, which is a to and fro motion of the particles, and this wave specifically is called a longitudinal wave. Put up the handout which was given in the previous class, ICE 1. To show them that there is molecule vibrations and how the wave is produced. Now, for the main creation, you split the class into groups of 5. Recall how molecule vibrations are causing the sound wave. Then, each group is given a piece of chalk and they can draw their own big wave in the classroom, on the floor. Note that the guide the groups in such a way that the wave is big enough for all the children to be able to stand on the wave and act like molecules or particles. Please note that if you have a small class, don't make 5 groups. You can make them into 3 groups. Once the children stand in the form of a wave, ask them to stand as particles in like this. So if you see, there's some children will need to come together and some will stay further away from each other. Once all the groups have settled themselves in the form of a wave, tell them now they've all formed a longitudinal wave. The part where the particles come together is called a compression. Ask the children to raise their hands, whoever is standing in the compression part. And the part where the children are away from each other is called a rarefaction. Ask children who are standing in the rarefaction area to raise their hands. With this, both the concepts of compression and rarefaction is known to the children. Once they are done with that, give them measuring tapes for each of the group, and the groups need to measure the distance between two highs or lows of the wave, the consecutive highs or the consecutive lows, and also the distance from the middle to the top of the wave. Both the measurements will be written on the board below each other as height of wave and distance between the highs and the lows. Once they're done with that activity, the students are given this worksheet where they need to draw a wave and label the compression and the rarefaction. Once all the students are done, they can come back and sit together in the same group pairs that they were sitting in the first opening. For this, they'll be using the model they made for the opening again. In this, one child needs to hold it against the ear and the other child will stretch it and pluck it at different distances. Like this. Once everyone is done, both the child has had a chance to hear the sound. Ask the children, was there a difference in the sounds that they heard? They'll say some was soft, some was loud, etc. This concept is explaining the concept of amplitude. Amplitude simply means the volume at which a sound can be heard. It is also the height of the wave. Stick up the handout ICE2, which explains that a longitudinal wave has an amplitude which is the height of the wave. Stick it up against the measurement that you'd already written on the board. For the next section, you make the children sit in the original pairs that they were sitting in the opening. They need to use the same model that they made for the opening for this activity. But the difference is, one child will be holding it against the ears. First you pluck it against the ear as usual. For the next time, you stretch the rubber band like this and let it pluck. You will hear a different sound. They can try it at different volumes and see what is the difference that they are hearing in the sound. Once both the child has had a chance to do this activity, ask them what was the difference in the sound that they heard. Students will say low or soft or loud, etc. and explain to them that this means it's the amplitude of the sound. Amplitude is the height of the wave. It is how high the wave travels. So the higher the wave is, the louder the sound, or the higher is the amplitude. In this, when you do the activity, when you stretch it at this distance, you hear a louder sound as opposed to here, which means the wave was higher at this point than when it was here. Now ask the children, what will happen when you talk on a mic? How do you hear the sound so loudly when the soft voice in the mic you put is so soft? So tell the children that there is a device called the amplifier which can make the sound wave bigger and therefore make it louder and amplified for humans to hear. In this example model, the stretching of the rubber band act as the amplifier. For the next part of the activity, you give each child a paper cup, a paper clip to make a small slit inside the paper cup, and a rubber band. Tie the rubber band in such a way that it is knotted at one end, and you put the knotted end inside the paper cup and take the unknotted end out. Hold the knotted end just to make it secure. For this, the child needs to pluck the rubber band at different lengths. As he keeps stretching the rubber band, he needs to keep plucking it and notice what is the difference in the sound. Ask the children, once they are done with plucking it at different lengths, what is the difference that they notice? Some children will say high or low or sharp or soft or things like that. Mention that as this is the number of times an object vibrates in a second is what you see changing as you stretch the rubber band. Okay? The more you stretch the rubber band, it vibrates more. When it comes closer, it's vibrating less. And this characteristics of a wave is called frequency. Frequency is the number of waves that is made in 1 second. If you notice here, this is more waves and this is less waves. So the more waves is called high frequency and lesser waves is called low frequency. This waves is showing how many oscillations happened in the time frame, and this is also showing the oscillation that happens in a time frame. Now, a wave also has another feature which is called the wavelength. The wavelength is the distance between two highs or two lows. We had already measured that distance here and kept it. So the wavelength of the different waves that the wave had has been mentioned here. Stick the wavelength display also on the board. As you see here, wavelength is the distance between two highs or two lows, which is here. The smaller the wavelength, the higher is the frequency. So for a wave which has very long wavelength compared to this, has low frequency, and which has small wavelength has high frequency. Have you noticed, ask the children if they have noticed an ambulance or a siren sound. They are really sharp sounding things to get people's attention. These are sounds which is high frequency. High frequency means low wavelength. Now make the children listen to a few sounds which is available in nature and ask them to guess if it is a high frequency or a low frequency sound. This is a high frequency sound. This is a low frequency sound. There are some other examples which you can make the children listen to and guess if it is a high frequency or a low frequency sound. Different people have different voice ranges and frequencies when they speak because of the stretching of the vocal cords. Depending on how much the vocal cords stretch, some people will sound different from somebody else. Have you noticed the voice of your mother and father, there is some difference? A boy and girl has some voice difference. It's because of the difference in the vocal cords. Now, frequency is measured in hertz, which is, the symbol is Hz. If there are 40 compressions happening in 1 second, the frequency of that sound wave is 40 hertz. That's how frequency and wavelength are measured. Now, we move on to the next characteristic of wavelength, which is speed. Recall with the children what are the three characteristics that they've learned so far: amplitude, wavelength, and frequency. Speed of a sound is the distance traveled by the sound in 1 second. Before you mention that to the children, ask them if they've seen and heard a thunder and lightning. Check with them which happens first. Do they hear the thunder first or do they see the lightning first? The children, the answer is that you see the lightning first. That is because light travels faster than sound, which means sound also has a speed. Speed of a sound is the distance it is covered in 1 second. See? After they are all done, you understand the four characteristics, you give them the worksheet which they need to fill in class and give it back to you. Students can ask for your help at this point or for their neighbor's help to fill this activity. Then we move on to the closure. You ask the children to say the word sound in different forms. Ask them to say the word with high amplitude. High amplitude means that you have to say it loudly. Low amplitude, it means you have to say it softly. High frequency means you have to say it very sharply. So it will be sound, or low frequency, sound. High wavelength means low frequency, which is sound. And last it is less wavelength, which is high frequency, which means it will sound like sound. With that, you tell them or also give them the at-home worksheet which they need to fill at home and bring it back for the next session. With this, the session is over. See you next week.